Hey guys, welcome to the CATKing CET daily series. Today we are going to be doing a very interesting topic called as the quantitative comparison. Similar to what we have done in data sufficiency yesterday. So make sure you guys, you know, are watching all of the videos. I hope these sessions have been really helpful for you. We've done a lot of things of vocabulary, critical reasoning, visual reasoning. So make sure you don't miss out any of these videos and log on every day to check out what's coming up next. All right. So let's understand the CET quantitative comparison based questions today. Okay. So basically quantitative comparison is nothing but where you'll be given two set of quantities, quantity A, quantity B. It could be anything. You have to compare which is greater, like quantity A is greater than B, B is greater than A. Or both of them are equal, or they cannot be a relation between the two. Remember, this option, which that the two are not related, usually does not happen when you have both of the entities being numericals. Because some or the other equation, whatever you solve, you would either get an answer them to be equal or greater or less than. Alright? So that's a very basic thing which you need to keep in mind. Now let's take a couple of examples to understand what kind of questions come in this. Okay, the first example for today is based on your geometry, okay, basic formulas of geometry. So you have a circle with AB as the diameter and the length of the diameter is 4. So my first quantity is circumference of the circle. Quantity B is the value 12. So that means I have to compare the value of circumference of the circle with 12. Okay, for people who don't know the formula of circumference of the circle, ensure you revise all your formulae of, you know, geometry and arithmetic, because it's very important when it comes to quantitative comparison as well as data sufficiency questions. That's going to be very helpful for you. Okay, so circumference of the circle by formula is given by pi d, and the value of pi is nothing but 3.14. so if I multiply, I will get 3.14 into 4. Definitely it's going to be more than 12, because 3 into 4 is 12. So my answer is pretty obvious. It's A is greater than B. Very simple. You will take less than 10 seconds for such kind of easy questions. But in the exam, we may not always get such easy questions. This is to understand what the type of questions are. The next two examples which I'm going to take are actual CET based questions, because you definitely get those kind of calculation based questions. Okay, so now let's look at this question where it's given. When you look at the question, the first thing is going to be, oh my god, it's so much calculations and I don't even have a calculator in the exam. So don't fret on such things, because you don't have to calculate. Okay, you have to do approximations. Now 32.8, I can take approximately as 33%. 5,929, I can approximate it to 6,000. Okay, so let's take that value of the quantity. I approximate to 33% of 6,000, but the final value has to be little less than that. So I've taken a minus sign there. Okay, now if you know conversions, like 1 by 2 is 50%, 1 by 3 is 33%, 1 by 4 is 25%, 1 by 5 is 20%, you should be knowing all of these things. Okay, so if I keep that conversion in mind, 33.3 is nothing but 1/3, right? 1/3 of 6,000 is nothing but 2,000. So my value is something less than 2,000. Okay, now let's come to quantity B. Here it is 41.6% of 5,041. I'll approximate to 40% of 5,000. Okay, so if I take 40% of 5,000, it's going to be 2,000, but it should be something higher because I reduced the values. So it becomes 2,000 plus. So how sweet this is. Now I have one quantity A which is less than 2,000, quantity B which is greater than 2,000. So my answer is pretty straightforward. Answer B is greater than A. Okay, so that's what you have to do. You don't have to calculate the exact answer, just do approximations and get to the conclusion which quantity is greater than the other one. All right, let's move on to one more example and see how well do you understand these concepts. Okay, now this is a very interesting example because this talks about comparing the different quantities. Okay, so here what we are doing is the fractions. Okay, the different elements. Now if I go by the traditional method, I'll first find the LCM and then go ahead. Quantity A is okay, I can calculate the LCM and, you know, go ahead with the same. But quantity B, it's going to be really taxing because 27 into 97, holy shit, you're going to go mad doing such kind of calculations, right? So remember, we don't have to do calculations. Now what we are going to do is we are going to just play with fractions around. Okay, now if you guys know, if I take a fraction and I increase its denominator, so the value will decrease, the final value. Yes, correct. Similarly, if I decrease the numerator, again the value will decrease. So that's what I'm going to do. I take 13 by 27. I increase the denominator by 1. That makes it 13 by 28. Then I decrease the numerator by 1. It becomes 12 by 28, which is going to be less than 13 by 27. Correct? Now, 12 by 28 can be solved as written as it is nothing but 3 by 7. You remove the common element 4. Okay? So that means my quantity B's first element is greater than the first element of quantity A. Alright? Same fashion I will do with the second element, which is 41 by 97. 97 we take it ahead to 100 and 41 we reduce it to 40. That makes it 40 by 100, which is nothing but 2 by 5. Correct? So what I have got is that both the elements, okay, 13 by 27 is greater than 3 by 7, 41 by 97 is greater than 2 by 5. That means my final answer is going to be B is greater than A. That's it. All I have done is played around with fractions without any calculations, LCM, all of them, cross multiplication, nothing to be done. All right. So remember, this is what you have to do. Play around with fractions, with equations, do approximations. That's all you need to do. Nothing else in quantitative comparison. You don't have to actually calculate the answer. So I hope the session has been helpful to you. All of you guys, please make sure you sign up to the CET Daily series. Don't miss out any of the videos. We'll be coming up further ahead also with a lot of shortcuts and tricks for all the sections of the exam. If you guys like the videos, feel free to drop in your comments and we'll make sure we take up all the feedback ahead and work on those topics as well also. All right, all the best. Do well.